My name is Whitney Ashley, and I work for Lord X Sargent, the architect of record for the Kendeda Building. Today I'm going to be talking about the water petal and the impact of the Living Building Challenge. The goal of the water petal for the Living Building Challenge is to capture rainfall, and it all starts from here, from the PV array, 913 solar panels. The water hits the PV array, falls down onto the gutter, and down the downspout into the rainwater system. And after the water goes through the rooftop drains, it goes through the first flush filter system, and that's where all the big debris, sediment, things like that are removed and then directed down to the cistern through these pipes. And this is the final destination where the rainwater ends to become potable drinking water. This is the water treatment center that has the micron stations here, and then also the UV treatment center here, which ends up into the day tanks. The potable water is included for the sinks, fountains, showers, and composting toilets. Gray water, which doesn't contain organic matter, is from the water fountains, sinks, and showers, which is directed into the primary tank for infiltration on site. This water will then be pumped to the constructed wetland in front of the building, where the water is then gravity fed into the surrounding site and infiltrate back into the soil to recharge the surrounding groundwater. Our building actually doesn't have a black water system, it has a composting toilet system. So it takes the mass from the toilets and brings it down and separates the mass from the liquids. The liquid from the composter goes to the bottom and is actually pumped up to the leachate tank. A third-party vendor empties the leachate tank about every 3 months, and then the composting bins usually don't have to be cleaned out for every 1 or 2 years based on usage. And these are a few ways that we're conserving water at the Kendeda Building. If you have any questions, you can stop by anytime and see the building.